Is it safe to feed raw food and kibble together? This is a commonly debated issue in the raw feeding community. An argument you often hear for why feeding kibble and raw together is dangerous is that these two foods digest at a different level of acidity, or gastric pH. It's assumed that kibble digests at a higher pH of around 4, which is less acidic, and raw meat and bone digests at a lower pH of 1 to 2, which means it's more acidic. So if you mix raw meat and bone with kibble, the overall gastric pH would be potentially less acidic with the addition of kibble, which would lead to pathogens not getting destroyed in the digestion process. The higher pH may also make it harder to break down bone properly. The second argument is that kibble takes longer to digest than raw, which also creates a risk of bacterial contamination, since the raw meat would be sitting in the GI tract much longer while also being less acidic. First of all, it's important to realize that the gastric pH doesn't stay constant. Let's start out by looking at the digestive process. It begins even before food enters your cat, dog, or ferret's mouth, when they start anticipating food. This triggers the gastric environment to become very acidic, which creates an optimal environment for enzymes such as pepsin to break down nutrients. With obligate carnivores like cats and ferrets, the digestion process begins once the food is swallowed. But with dogs who eat a carb-based diet, it begins in the mouth, as their saliva contains amylase that helps break the starches down. Dogs, cats, and ferrets are likely to produce up to 100 times the amount of acid than that of a human, which on a side note is a clear indicator that it was meant to handle raw meat and bone. Once the food is digested, the gastric pH goes back up while the body sends signals to neutralize the acid before the food mixture enters the small intestine. The small intestines are where any beneficial nutrients are absorbed into the bloodstream. Although there are no current studies out about the gastric pH of raw-fed domestic pets, there are a few on pets fed dry food. A few of these studies found that the pH of both dogs and cats fed dry food are actually quite low, on an average pH of 2. So how about kibble and raw digesting at different rates or speed? Well, different types of food will digest differently for all organisms. For example, humans can digest some vegetables in less than a day due to high concentrations of fiber, while red meat may sometimes take up to 2 days to fully digest. There aren't any scientific studies out there as of yet showing the digestion process between raw-fed dogs and kibble-fed dogs, but the rawfeedingcommunity.com conducted their own small experiment. In this experiment, they fed an adult dog dry food for 1 day and raw food a week later. They took radiographs every few hours to compare the digestion process. To the raw feeders that believed that kibble digested at a slower rate, this probably comes to a surprise. The results showed that kibble actually digested much quicker than raw meat and bone. After 5 hours, the kibble was already in the colon, where with the raw food, most of the muscle meat was entering the colon, but much of the bone still had yet to enter the small intestines. While this is only one experiment on one dog, these results can help us understand our pet's digestive process a bit better. These findings are actually great news. This means that the myth of feeding raw and kibble together is harmful now shows little credibility. Secondly, food remaining in the intestines longer means more water will be absorbed, thus leading to a smaller stool. And most importantly, food remaining in the GI tract for a longer period of time means that more nutrients are able to be absorbed and utilized. So, what do we know? 1. Kibble-fed pets still maintain a healthy gastric pH, meaning that pathogens from raw meat will not cause harm to the body because the acid quickly destroys it. And 2, all nutrients are digested differently, and the GI system is designed to break down foods at different rates depending on the food's structure. For example, lean muscle meat digests quickly, while raw fat takes another step before entering the small intestine. And raw bone will be digested the slowest because of its density. I do want to note that every pet is different, and pets with weakened immune systems or a sensitive GI system may not do as well eating raw and kibble, so figure out what works best for your individual animal. Some things that help with this are probiotic supplements or kefir. Lastly, just like when switching different kibble brands, your pet's body has to get used to the new food and may experience some loose stool when being introduced to raw food. If you're still apprehensive of feeding raw and kibble together, you can always feed raw in the morning and kibble in the evening. So that way your dog's digestive system has processed the one type of food and can begin processing the other later in the day. If you want to learn more about transitioning from kibble to raw, check these videos out.